is always nice to see you. New York City, baby, let's go!
Alrighty, we have made it. Yeah, we're gonna go meet up with Cannon, Justice, whole gang, get some breakfast, and we're gonna lift. I'm so excited to be here, though.
I'm tired of the darkness.
NYC, baby. I feel like Casey Neistat out here.
So I got a ticket for not riding in the bike lane, but often there are obstructions that keep you from properly riding in the bike lane.
Let's go, bro. That was a lot of great.
It must have been something you said. I just died in your arms tonight.
Where are we going?
The top now, baby. Dog it. Let's go.
Reagan, how's your workout?
Oh, excellent.
Excellent.
First stop.
All right, we just wrapped up quick workout at, what was that called? What was that?
Temple.
Yeah. Shout out to people at Temple.
They hooked us up. Shout out Eduardo.
Eduardo from Temple hooked us up.
Nice guy.
How'd you pull it off, Justice?
So, guys, just pull off anything. Just talk to people, be nice, and it's going to come back to you, I promise.
It's all about the vocabulary.
It is. Increase your vocab. You can just convince people to do. I know it sounds bad, but basically do what you want.
I can turn off cross.
Post-workout. Post-workout cake.
25 grams of protein.
Fire.
And she hates red velvet.
Really?
Yeah.
Waiting to go out here.
Zach, do you think you're aesthetic?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So Zach is fucking tiny, bro.
You're so small.
It's actually funny.
You're the smallest in the vision.
Sorry, bro.
Sorry.
This is not true. Unfortunately. Fuck.
Cervix.
Yeah, it's like that.
No.
The cervix?
The cervix.
Nice. Like, I don't know.
I mean, how these people don't understand
social media. Kids from my high school ask how I make money from what I do, and it just boggles my mind. And they're just sitting in college, asking.
Right.
It's just a matter of doing it. If you sit there asking, thinking you're going to get stuck, and you're going to end up in the system of going to high school, getting a 9-to-5 job, and you'll be stuck in the rat race. So the only way to break it is just start doing stuff for yourself.
Right? You just learn straight from experience.
Experience, yeah. You have to learn from yourself and the mistakes, and just not learn to not repeat them.
Exactly. Just fucking throw money at shit that you believe in and
hey, yeah, dude, dream. The only reason people don't
that's what
make
I
their
do.
Dreams come true is because they give up on
this
it.
Is a podcast, bro.
No, you literally
no, it is.
Yo Club, I started with $500. I started my business with $500 in July of 2020, and then July of 2021, we did almost 6 figures in that single month. And I learned so much. And then now what I do, I fucked up so much before that, but now I understand. And then, well, me in a year from now, I'm going to think I'm stupid in this present.
How much more you know. Alright. Podcast is over, guys.
The business mastermind.
You're
just going ham.
Yeah. Going ham or going turkey? I almost
how about
the
going tofu?
You
vegan!
Vegan alert! Vegan alert!
This chick.
What are you doing?
That's what
we're waxing. You gotta get a big.
Alright, guys. Mr. Protein's toenails are like...
Alright, guys, so we're here in New York right now. I'm getting my legs waxed for the first time, so wish me luck, guys. I'm gonna try to keep a straight face the entire time. That's my goal.
Not ready.
But that feels really hard.
Oh, man. Ooh.
Is that right?
Oh, yeah.
Yummy.
Give me
that. Yummy. Okay, we need it to be hotter. Yeah, we're not gonna get it
fun. So piece by piece, Jaden's just pulling one hair at a time.
Cut! There's on the train, so that was very entertaining. Yeah, there's weird entertainers, but it was funny.
I'm gonna regret all this footage. So, we are back at the hotel room. I actually have to check out right now. It's already like 10:30 and I've checked out at 11. Last night was unreal. Like, the club we went to was playing like the best EDM. I'm a huge EDM guy. It was like house music, so it was like Kygo, Tropical. Like, it was just on like perfect vibe. Right now I need to actually pack up and get ready to go. Today we're gonna have a full day of activities. We have some sales calls actually later in the day. I'm gonna document that. But yeah, I'm gonna shower and then I'm gonna go find out what everyone else is doing. So a while ago, I posted my stance on alcohol. I think it's probably my sophomore year of college. And I was like, I thought like drinking overall was pointless. Like I didn't drink basically at all. And that was really good for a long time. Like I was in a period of grinding, my head was down, things were getting done. I was extremely focused. I basically come to the conclusion that it's good to celebrate when you have something to celebrate for. Meaning like if it's a good event, if you're meeting your business partners, if you're on a trip, if you're, you know, if you're going to these things and celebrating your success, your wins, you can lay off, have a few drinks, have a good time. Because last night I had a few drinks and it was unreal, super fun, and had a great time with the whole crew on Wins. So, you know, if you're maybe younger and you're like, I don't know, you know, a lot of people are drinking every single Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Like, I think the concept of, you know, do it when you have something to celebrate for is very sound. It's a good, happy balance and allows you to have fun and have a good time when it's right. So that's my stance on it. Some might disagree, some might agree. I'm largely against, I'll probably drink once every 2 months, maybe. I think that's my rate right now. So obviously it's a rare occasion, but when it happens, you know, usually it's because something is to celebrate for.
Change your voicemails.
Hi, this is Zachary. Sorry, I couldn't get to the phone right now. If you could please.
The big one? Yeah, yeah, I wanted a big white chocolate.
Good morning.
Morning.
So I wasn't gonna stay another night, but Ken and Reagan offered me one of the best spots in their room to sleep.
And it was right here. Slept all night right here.
And it wasn't too bad, but my back is fucked. My back's really fucked up, but.
Cue the video from last night.
Do you have a video of it?
Yeah.
Well, cue the video right here. Good night, guys. Good night, Reagan. But yeah, it's now Sunday, going to be heading out of here soon, driving back to Boston, but it has been a blast.
Getting ready to make some sales calls, baby.
Getting ready to make some sales.
Closing a bunch of deals for TVG. on to the moon. We already got the plan for this summer. We're gonna be going to the office at 6 a.m. We're gonna have our morning meeting, make a bunch of sales calls, eat lunch, and then one final sales call, close a big deal, go to the gym, hype, playing Tevez, to hidden gym for this Dallas and get huge with the boys. The content's gonna be mad.
And also, I'm gonna be back with these creatures in like 6 days because Abby's show. So we're gonna be going to Texas on Wednesday. It's currently Sunday. I have class this week, and then I'm back with the CEO.
We're pulling up to Abby's show. She's gonna take the dub, and then we're just gonna kick it in Dallas.
Okay, more, but then we're moving to
Dallas. Then we're moving to Dallas for next week, the week after.
Yes!
Freshest meat you can get, baby.
New York City streets.
Yes, sir.
Best meat.
Yes, sir.
I do know. And funny, I have a Starlink unit for my house out in the sticks.
All right, we are heading back to Massachusetts because I need to go back to school. I'm gonna be back with them in literally 6 days. That is a very small little hint of what's to come, especially once I'm out of school. Basically, I'm moving to Texas to live with those guys along with a bunch of other like-minded people that were all just hustling, growing businesses in the fitness space. Justice is crushing it and we're working on a project together, which I'm excited to tell you guys more about. And let me just tell you that the only reason why I'm connected with people like that is because of content, because I put myself out there, I tell people what I'm all about, I work my ass off, and people resonate with that. But while it's easy to get hung up on like the likes, the followers, the vanity metrics, all that stuff, the fact that I'm with these people, it's not because I'm famous, it's because I provide value to them, we're working on cool shit, and you know, we all believe in each other. We're going to make some solid moves. We already are making huge moves in the industry. So yeah, I'm driving back to Massachusetts. I can't wait to go through all this footage. It's gonna be so fun.